Hello, fans, and welcome to tonight's game between the Notre Dame Fighting Irish and the DePaul Blue Demons. And, of course, we look here at our star watch. And, of course, here's our starting lineup.
Check out these playmakers. The kids at the point should give us a show tonight.
And the referee is ready to toss it up.
And the first half is underway, baby.
Working it around the perimeter. Ball down low, puts it on the floor. It's around a fadeaway. Farrell receives the pass. The Fighting Irish set up into their zone motion offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
The point guard gets the pass. Both teams looking to get things going here. Way out on top, controlling the ball. He shoots the jumper. And nice looking jumper in the lane. The Blue Demons did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
Certain offense is required as the ball goes through the high post. This will usually open up things on the wings and a low block, Brad. They did a great job of using the high post on that play.
He lets it fly. Nails the fadeaway. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. For the bucket. Makes it.
Defense breaks down again. Nobody rotates over from the help side.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. He shoots from the corner. Nails a sweet jumper. Gave it up. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper.
It inside.
Loose ball, saves it. Great play for two. Off the glass and no good. There's a double team waiting there. Out on the right wing, tries for two, scorches the net. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Dumps it in. He fires it up. Can't get the shot to go. On the dribble, gives it up.
Gotta think right now. Gotta focus defensively.
Gets the J to fall. Takes it strong to the hoop.
He knows how to use his strength, Brad. That's such an important skill. You've got to know how to use it without being called for the foul.
Out on the left wing. There's the block. Off the mark. The shooting guard takes the pass.
There's the trap.
Definitely a foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. You know, seniors are important because they bring so much to the team. Leadership, motivation, and a sense of accountability. It's their last year, so you know they want to make it a memorable one.
This is the team's first trip to the free throw line. Gets two at the charity stripe. The Blue Demons running their zone offense here, Dick.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
Buries it. What a pass on the backdoor cut.
That was a great cut and feed, Brad. A perfectly timed read.
They working around the perimeter. Goes up for two. You betcha. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
Misses the second shot. Harvey receives the ball. The Fighting Irish now running a zone offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Matt. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Number 10 handles the feed. He puts up the J. Nails the jumper. He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
Looking for a good shot. For the bucket. He hits it. He manages to keep it in play. Oh, he dribbled the ball out of bounds. The inbound. The Blue Demons go into their zone motion now. In the lane.
Hey, you should know by now you don't leave your guy open.
Not a very smart move. Now they work it around the perimeter. From the corner. Can't connect. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
Pushes it up. Both teams looking to get things going here. Moving it around the perimeter. Here's a double team. Nails the J. They work the perimeter. For two. Shots off the mark. Harvey receives the pass. Pushes it up. Takes the jumper and come up short. Kane receives the pass. Tries for two. Not there. The shooting guard gets the pass. Pushes it up. Loose ball. Great play. Goes up for two. Goes in. They'll work it around the arc. Burns picks up the foul. Second team foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Number 31 to the line for two. He makes the first shot.
Nothing but nylon, MBN.
Oh, this man's in trouble. Into their zone motion now. Down to the low block, try to work inside. Goes. Number 30 receives the ball. They work it around the perimeter. He launches a three. The missed shot. Farrell handles the pass. Turnaround jumper. That is a dagger in the heart, that shot, Dick.
Hey, they lost focus here. They need a timeout to regroup, Rod.
Inside for the bucket. Jumper won't go. The shooting guard takes the pass. Jumper knocked it down. We'll see who's got more coming out of this timeout as play resumes. The Blue Demons set up into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key in the zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Turnaround jumper. He's taking two men. They get that rejected. You can't go those kind of stretches against a team of this quality and expect to win. From the top of the circle, scores it. And we're at the 8-minute mark. And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
So, Dick's so important now at the point. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
There may be a pick and roll here, Dick.
You've got to love the pick and roll, especially when it's run to perfection, Brad.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
The Blue Demons have had their struggles as a team from the free throw line, Dick.
As a team, they need to improve in this department. Poor team free throw shooting costs a lot of teams games.
They got them both. The Fighting Irish are going into their zone motion offense now. On the outside, number 30 is charged with the foul. Second team foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time. He buries it. Second one is no good. The small forward takes the pass. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. The point guard gets the pass. He attempts the jump shot. Busts the J. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Gave it up. Puts up the J. Knocks it down. He cut back door and the pass was delivered perfect.
It's great seeing those types of plays. That's team basketball. Look at that spacing.
Launches the three. I don't think that's the guy they want shooting that shot.
Hey, Brad, their shot selection has been questionable. Too many outside jumpers. They've got to attack inside and then out.
Both teams looking to get things going here. Try to pack it inside. Arm and foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
So he'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity.
Irish lead as we head to this timeout. Get ready to bounce back into action here. Had a momentary look from three-point land. For two, bust the jumper.
Trying to go inside.
With the jumper. Off the glass and no good. Good job defensively. They just won't give many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
The Fighting Irish are going into their zone motion offense now. The point guard with the ball. They look to get it to the inside. Goes up. They got it. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, the four around one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
On the dribble, gives it up. The Fighting Irish set up into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
Gave it up. Jumper. Gets the J to fall. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. Looking to move it around the perimeter. Now the turnaround jumper. Off the mark. He cleans the glass. Pushes it up. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Tries for two. He drains the shot. Good cut, great pass right there.
Great recognition by both players. The backdoor cut is one of those types of plays you love to see.
From left of the circle. Nope. The Fighting Irish can definitely be classified as an up-tempo team. Wouldn't you agree with that, Dick?
They definitely want to run, Brad. They want to run faster and longer than their opponents every time they step on a court. It's a style of play which is tough to keep up with.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Ball's going to stay here. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Dick.
I tell you, as a coach, Brad, it's always nice to have a player surprisingly step up and perform better than expected. We'll have to keep a close eye on him moving forward.
The offense sets up from the sideline. The Blue Demons go into their zone motion now. There's a slam. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
And now, getting set up here in a four around one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility, who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Goes up for two. He can't get the bucket to fall. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Coach has been quite animated over here on the sidelines. It's all positive, though. He's pleased with the manner in which they're playing their up-tempo style. I overheard him saying that if this continues, he likes his team's chances. Guys?
That's, of course, Aaron Andrews, our correspondent on the sideline. On the dribble, gives it up. Hard foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Number 10 is going to the charity line. Free throw is good. Shot is not good. Farrell handles the feed for the bucket. He nails the bucket. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
For two. Great shot. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
About a minute remaining. Number 31 gets the ball. He bangs it in for another score.
And the hits just keep coming on, baby.
Go into the low block. Takes his jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
trying to feed the low block. Goes up with a shot. Jumper won't go. Shot clock is dead. He shoots from outside. It won't fall. Tries for two. Buried it. The Blue Demons move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps in the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots.
At halftime, the Blue Demons are down by 12. DePaul is losing in the battle on the boards in the first half, Dick.
Yeah, the opposing team was clearly more committed to rebound than the rock.
And here's a look at what each team here today will be focusing on when we get things underway.
Tell you what, you can get a sense of the story of this game by looking at some of these numbers. Still lots of time to play, though. Anything can happen.
Looks like a full-court man-to-man press, Mr. Vitale.
It looks as though they have a shooter spotting up.
With the J. Off the mark. Pushes it up. The turn, a fadeaway jumper. Missed it. Takes the jumper. Knocked it down. Zone motion now. That's a momentum buster.
He's here to fight, baby.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Nails a sweet jumper. That's one of the best parts of college basketball, the student section. They're fired up and they're ready to try to help their team.
The student body looks like they're ready to terrorize the opposition.
The point guard gets the pass. Little two-man action. Way out on top, controlling the ball. 10 to shoot now. He looks at the hoop, puts up the J, busts the jumper. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
Looking for a good shot. He goes up with it.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly. Pressure that basketball, help one another, communicate.
He attempts the three and come up short. Zone offense now. The point guard with the ball. Goes up for two. Drains it. And now getting set up here to four round one.
I'll tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
The Fighting Irish have the lead. Timeout call. We've got a break in the action. Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court.
Steal, go up the other way, get a layup.
On the outside. For the bucket. Nice shot. His shot rejected.
Rejection.
Number 31 takes the feed.
Coach looks on, focused, a lot of intensity, a lot of emotion.
He tries the jumper. They're having a real tough time hitting from the floor.
Wow, I'm speechless, Brad, and you know that never happens. I don't know what to say. They couldn't be shooting the ball any worse.
They move it into the front court. Working it around the perimeter. Number 10 is called for the foul. First personal foul. It's been a great team effort for these guys tonight, Nick.
They've been awesome, Brad. Every player who has stepped onto the court has been focused and has been looking to get his team involved. You've got to love this kind of teamwork.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Kane handles the pass. For two. There was no doubt about that one. Pulls up with a jumper. Missed the jumper. Pushes it up.
Gotta take some quiet on the defensive end.
And they get the turnover. Now looking to attack. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Tries for two. He buries it. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open jumper. He shoots from the corner. Nope. Gave it up.
I tell you, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards out there.
Yeah, that helps. Goes up for two. He gets it to go. How do you slow these guys up?
They've got to start hitting some shots on their own. Team now, bad angle.
They go with the entry pass on the post. Turnaround jumper. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I love the four around one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot. Up and inside.
He'll take the shot. I wonder if he's ever going to get any help from his teammates, Dick. He's doing it all and then some.
He's a one-man show at the moment. He can't get any help from his teammates.
Let's take another look at this deep three. The Blue Demons now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Once again, let's take a look at our star watch. Ball coming in from the sideline. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Reed receives the pass, trying to pack it inside, puts it on the floor and up and under.
I'll tell you, really, a part of the offensive plan is to teach your post players to utilize that up and under move, and he does it exceptionally well.
The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
They want to win just as bad as anyone else in the building.
Here comes the ball screen. And now they'll bring it up. He hammers it home. The bucket, and he misses the shot. Dick, how do these guys stay so fresh on defense?
Hey, three words, Brad. Rotation, rotation, and rotation. They're playing like a true team out there, supporting one another when there's a breakdown.
They're working around the perimeter. Goes up with it. Can't connect. And we're at the 8-minute mark. Looking for a good shot.
Tempo of the game, really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Now they work it around the perimeter. He shoots from the deep corner. Jumper won't go. The Fighting Irish go into their zone motion now.
A human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
How about this display shooting from deep, Dick?
They're playing in a way which is getting them some nice looks from long range. Not only are they fighting guys, but guys are getting their feet set and are knocking down the shot.
The pass. With a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through.
I'll tell you, you're going to be exceptional to make that shot because a lot of coaches don't like it because you're going away. You're not in rebound position. You better make it count.
We're at the 7-minute mark. Inside. Goes up. The missed shot. The Fighting Irish are going into their zone motion offense now.
Excellent jump shot right there. Try to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Kane handles the pass. Jumper. They get it to go. 6 minutes left in the game clock. Trying to feed inside. He shoots the jumper. Off the mark. Moving it around the perimeter. lobs it for two. In the paint. Goes up for two. Two with a lay-in. Well, partner, this one could go right down to the wire.
You've got to love these close ones, Brad. Every error is magnified and could be the difference between a win or a loss.
They work the perimeter. Shoots from the outside. No. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
For the deuce, he drains the bucket. The Blue Demons move into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
He misses it. They'll work it around the arc. 4 minutes left on the game clock.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Goes up. He misses the jumper. The point guard handles the feed. Dumps it in. He shoots the jumper. He makes the jumper. The Blue Demons are going to have to desert any ideas of playing in the half court now, Dick, with the score differential where it is and the clock winding down.
They've got to score quick and get some defensive stops, Brad. They don't usually play up tempo, but they're going to have to do it now.
The Fighting Irish are going to try to hold on to the lead here, but should probably do so by playing in the half court as opposed to that up-tempo style, Dick.
At this point, playing in the half court would be a wise move. They don't really need to score, but do need for time to come off the clock.
And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, the four-round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Cross court. That's good. Great job of occupying the high post, which ultimately leads to a scoring opportunity.
Well, they're doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Tries for two. Rims out. About 2 minutes remaining on the game clock. They work it around the perimeter. Change of possession. That one deserves another look.
Hey, when you can finish above the rim, you've got nothing to worry about, my friend. You should always throw it down, and you have the chance.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
On the outside. Oh, and it's blocked.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
And the ball is saved. Great job. The Blue Demons go into their zone motion now. He pulls up with a jumper. He's taking a lot of bad shots out there, Dick.
I know. He's trying to catch fire, Brad, but it's just not there.
On the dribble, gives it up. He goes for three. He misses the fadeaway.
A Buccaneer will make this a two-possession game.
Timeout on the floor. Aaron Andrews, what do you got for us, EA?
As you guys know, free throw shooting becomes very important down the stretch. The coaching staff is aware of this, and we'll be talking about this in the timeout. It'll be up to the players to knock them down.
What mindset, Dick, do coaches want their players to have when they leave a timeout?
Well, for me, Brad, I wanted my players to have a clear understanding of what the objectives were for the upcoming possessions. Timeouts are a great way to get your team back on track and a way to really alter the tempo of the game. Great coaches have a knack for calling timeouts at the right times.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. 6 points separating these two squads.
This is no time to get complacent, Brad.
For the bucket. Rims out, and the shot blocked.
He saw an opening, but the gap closed up in a hurry.
He's got to look to kick that out once the zone collapses like that.
Sometimes timeouts can take teams right out of their rhythm, Brad. Let's see what happens here.
Offensively, they get into their zone motion. He shoots from outside. Questionable shot selection there.
Yeah, I'm not sure what he was thinking there.
Well, it's time to start fouling. They got to stop the clock, Dick. I think that one deserves another look.
Hey, look at him hammer this one down. Send a message, young man. Send a message.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock. Clock stop with a foul. Foul, and that stops the clock again.
I like it when the team gets to the free throw line. It shows that they're being aggressive. The key is to get to the line early in the game and often.
The players got a much needed breather with that timeout. Pushes it. Zone offense now. Cross court. Turnaround jumper.
I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
It's a four-point game.
This one could go either way. Don't give up your seat.
He'll visit the charity stripe. Makes the shot. Makes it. Coming out of the timeout, I'd expect we're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
Offensively, they get into their zone motion.
That's basic.
With the big shot. And come up short. DePaul accepts a difficult loss.
It's tough to lose such a close game, but these kids can hold their heads up high with the effort they put forth.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.